Hello students, welcome to our new English class. Our topic is today is about natural disasters and phenomena. We are going to talk about the vocabulary. So, what is a natural disaster? A natural disaster is a catastrophic event which is caused by the natural process is in nature. The natural process of the earth, it's not man-made, but it has a harsh effect on people and causes great damage, destruction, and even loss of life. ¿No? ¿Qué es un desastre natural? Dice que es un evento catastrófico, el cual es causado por el proceso natural. Un proceso natural de la Tierra. Esto es por el efecto en las personas. Esto causa a las personas, ¿no?, destrucción, daños y a veces pérdidas de vidas. This lesson will provide you with valuable English vocabulary used to talk about natural disaster. Okay, en esta lección aprenderemos vocabulario usando de cómo hablar sobre los desastres naturales. Expanding your vocabulary is key to improving your English fluency. So this lesson includes 9 natural disasters and variety of useful English expressions. So today we are gonna talk about 9 different types of natural disasters, along with other useful vocabulary that you can use to discuss these natural disasters in English. Okay, vamos a ver 9 tipos de desastres naturales con su vocabulario que podemos usar para discutir este tema en inglés, ¿no? So the first natural disaster is wildfire. Wildfires are often referred to a forest fire or bush fire. Okay? These are uncontrollable fires that start in places where there is a lot of vegetation, such as grass or forest. What is the meaning of wildfire? Incendios forestales. Okay. What is it? Says that it is referred as a forest, ¿no? Incendios forestales. Fuegos incontrolables que empiezan de un lugar donde hay mucha vegetación, como grass o diferentes tipos de plantas o árboles, right? You might remember a couple of years ago there were harsh forest fires all over different parts of Australia. ¿Recuerdan el incendio forestal que hubo en diferentes partes de Australia? Forest fires can occur natural and can happen as a result of things such as lightning, strike, or combustion due to hot, dry temperatures. Okay, un incendio forestal puede causarse de la naturaleza, ¿no?, por resultados de cosas como inundaciones. Esto puede ser un rayo, ¿no?, a lightning strike, o combustible, o debido a la temperatura caliente. So the result is that the forest or the bush will start burning out of control and the fire is unable to be stopped. ¿No? El resultado de esto empieza quemando fuera de control y el fuego no puede ser detenido. There is a place in Canada called Fort McMurray which often has difficulties with wildfires. However, recently Fort McMurray was in the news because they were suffering damage caused by a flood. Right? Okay, dice, hay un lugar en Canadá llamado Fort McMurray donde siempre tienen dificultades con este tipo de desastres, incendios forestales, y estuvo últimamente en las noticias donde provocó daños por una inundación, flood. So, our second type of natural disaster for today's lesson is a flood. What is a flood? A flood is when water covers part of the earth's surface that are not usually covered or submerged in water. Okay, what is a flood? The meaning of flood is inundación, right? What is a flood? Cuando el agua cubre todas las partes de la tierra, ¿no? De una ciudad of a city that is not usually covered or submerged in water. And it happened as a result of river overflowing their banks. What happened if snow melt too rapidly? Okay, es ocurrido por los ríos que se desbordan, ¿no? Se desbordan los ríos, so it's gonna happen a flood. Pasaría a una inundación. So it can also happen if there is too much rain or things that have happened, such as thunderstorms or hurricanes or tsunamis, which we'll talk about later. Okay, también dice que es puede pasar cuando hay mucha lluvia o pasado alguna tormenta, ¿no? Algún huracán o algún tsunami. Flood can be very serious because they cause lots of damage, ¿no? Una inundación puede ser muy serio porque puede causar mucho daño. And people could drown in a flood. So to drown means that you have too much water on top of you and you can't breathe, so you end up, right? Si tú estás en una inundación, puedes ahogarte y puedes morirte. Puedes, te falta respiración, ¿no? So, the third natural disaster is a drought. What is a drought? A drought is when there is no rain for a long time. Okay, cuando, so the meaning is sequía, right? Cuando no hay nada de lluvia. When there is no rain for a long period of time. No hay lluvia por nada. For months or for years, there is no precipitation. O sea, por meses o por años, no hay precipitaciones. No rain, no lluvia. Precipitation means rain or snow or other moisture, ¿no? Precipitaciones significa lluvias o nieve falling to the ground, ¿no? Cayendo. So there is a lot of water. And as a result, the ground becomes very dry, ¿no? Esta falta de agua y como resultado, obviamente, no crece alimentación para las personas. So becomes very dry, ¿no? Llega a ser todo seco. And causes difficult producing agriculture, ¿no? Y causa dificultades para producir la agricultura. Right? Which means that farmers cannot create enough food. No significa que los agricultores no pueden crear nada de comida. Which doesn't mean that people go hungry and start to starve. No, las personas empiezan a morirse de hambre y comienzan a hear the hambruna. They are starving due to the lack of food. ¿No? Empieza la hambruna. It's called famine. Famine is hambruna. O debido a la falta de comida. Right? So famines are the main problem that occurs as a result of a drought. ¿No? Dice que la hambruna es el principal problema que ocurre como resultado de la sequía. So the fourth disaster The fourth natural disaster for today is an earthquake. What is an earthquake? So quake is a word in English which means to shake, bouncing. Quake, quake significa it's the same of shake, like sacudir, no? So an earthquake is basically when the earth starts shaking, right? Earthquake means terremoto, right? It says it's basically when the earth, cuando la tierra comienza a temblar. And the shaking is called because underneath the earth surface there are things are tectonic plates, and when these plates move, okay, por las placas tectónicas, dicen la superficie de la tierra, por eso es causado el movimiento. Which happens naturally when they move, it goes to earth to begin shaking a lot, okay, ¿no? Que pasa obviamente naturalmente, donde ellos se mueven, causa que la tierra tiemble demasiado. The place where the plate chips is where the most damage, ¿no? El lugar donde se mueve más es peligroso. From there where it goes and then going out, right? From that point there is lesser damage. So just main point where the incident has occurred is called the epicenter, ¿no? El punto principal donde el incidente o el terremoto ocurre es llamado el epicentro. We can measure the strength of the earthquake when we do this. We are looking to measure the magnitude of the earthquake, okay? Vemos la magnitud del terremoto. Magnitude means how strong was that shaking, ¿no? Magnitude significa qué tan fuerte fue el movimiento, la sacudida. The way we measure the magnitude of earthquake is with something called the Richter scale, ¿no? Como miden la magnitud es con algo llamado escala de Richter, ¿no? You know, right? If there is an earthquake with is only around 3 or less on the Richter scale, ¿no? Si hay un terremoto el cual está menos de los 3 escala de Richter, it probably will not cause any damage and will probably not be seen as a disaster. No, probablemente que no cause mucho daño, probablemente no se vea como un desastre. But, however, an earthquake that is 7, 7.8, 8, and 9, and so on, those types of earthquakes are the ones that cause the great disaster. ¿No? Si un terremoto está entre los 7, 7.8, 8, 9, este tipo de terremoto causa el más grande desastre. Entire cities, buildings, everything just completely destroyed. ¿No? Todo está destruido, ciudades, departamentos, todo se destruye. By the shaking of the earth, ¿no? Por el movimiento de la tierra. Sometimes these shakes are also referred to as tremors, ¿no? A veces estos movimientos son referidos como temblores. The earth is trembling and you are experiencing some tremors. After the earthquake has finished, you might still experience a little bit of shaking, maybe hours or days later, ¿no? Te quedas con la experiencia del terremoto que has vivido. So, once a large earthquake has occurred, natural disaster number 5 is a tsunami. What is a tsunami? Often occurs as a result of an earthquake. ¿No? Un tsunami siempre pasa después de un resultado de un terremoto. But, what is it? Can help you to mind what a tsunami is. It's a giant wave or series of waves that are coming up over the harbor and onto the land. ¿no? Tsunami es grandes olas causadas por un movimiento violento de la tierra, ¿no? So the waves can often be caused as a result of the tectonic plates. Las olas pueden ser causadas de un resultado de las placas tectónicas, right? Shifting and creating this extra force with the weights. Back in 2018 in March, remember in Japan, there was a really large earthquake. You might remember that thing also caused a high tsunami and caused massive destruction in Japan, ¿no? Por ahí, pero el 2011 hubo un gran terremoto donde también ocurrió un tsunami causando masiva destrucción en Japón. So our next natural disaster, number 6, is a hurricane. A hurricane might also be known as cyclone or a typhoon. These three different words, hurricane, cyclone, or typhoon, are used in different areas of the world where is a similar natural disaster happen. However, all three of these take place connected to the coastal areas. Areas that are close to bodies of water, such as the ocean or the sea. Now, a hurricane is a giant spiraling tropical storm with very fast wind. So, a hurricane is a violent wind that has a circular movement. No es un viento violento, dice que da movimientos circulares. So, especially in the West Atlantic Ocean, especialmente en el Océano Atlántico. So, and with this very fast spiral and spinning winds also comes a lot of raining. No, también dice que viene mucha lluvia. So in addition to the strong winds and heavy rain, this spinning of the cyclone causes a lot of damage. También provoca mucho daño, ¿no? Causa demasiado daño. Todo este movimiento circular que da en la tierra provoca mucho daño. So, especially in the hurricane in the very center, this is an area like this where the most damage is caused as it's spinning. So, our next natural disaster, number seven, is similar to a hurricane, but slightly different. No, el siguiente es casi parecido al huracán, pero un poco diferente. It's a tornado. Hurricanes usually occur in coastal areas. No, el huracán usualmente ocurre en las áreas de la costa, whereas tornadoes usually occur just inland. A tornado is also a spiraling spinning funnel like cloud that comes along and just widening out with its massive wings. A tornado, you can clearly see in the sky that it's connected to a thunder cloud and to the earth's surface. No, a tornado, a strong dangerous wind. It's the same, similar that a hurricane. No es similar que un huracán, dice. Igual con vientos peligrosos que forman un círculo, una espiral, right? Hay espiral, algo redondo, así. Con mucho viento, and is able to destroy buildings, ¿no? Y es capaz de destruir todo lo que se le cruza alrededor. So you can directly see this connection as the winds are spinning, ¿no? Puedes ver directamente la conexión del viento como desborda todo alrededor de él. Another word for a tornado is actually a twister, because the wind is literally twisting even everything like this. And as the fast winds are twisting, they are also picking up debris and ripping up houses off the ground and things like that as they go along. So they have been many disastrous movies made about tornadoes, and even one feature in the plot of one of my favorite movies, The Wizard of Oz. No, hay varias películas de desastres naturales hechas sobre hablar que hablan sobre los tornados. No, maybe sometimes there are no real and some are real. No, algunos son reales, algunas no son reales. So our natural disaster number 8 is a volcanic eruption. So when you have a volcano and the gases and heat inside the volcano suddenly explode, this is called an eruption in English. No? Dice que es of relating to or made by a volcano, a mountain with a hole at the top through which hot liquid rod is or has been forced out. Sale un líquido de las rocas. And this causes great damage because of three different elements. ¿No? Y causa, que puede causar grandes daños, igual, por tres diferentes elementos. That are coming out of the volcano as it erupts, ¿no? Cuando erupciona. One thing is deadly gases, ¿no? Una cosa es que sale gases que pueden ocasionar la muerte. Another thing is the lava. The lava is the hot molten like liquid rock that is coming from the magma in the earth. ¿No? La lava es un líquido de rocas que quema demasiado, obviamente, right? And the third thing is the ashes that are coming out of the volcano. ¿No? El humo que también puede generar peligro. The ashes and the smoke could cause a lot of damage, ¿no? Que pueden ocasionar mucho daño para las personas. We can't sleep, right? No podemos respirar. It says ash is when you are burning something, the black orb, right? Cuando algo se está quemando, sale demasiado humo, uno no puede respirar, right? For natural disaster number 9, I am putting two different. Okay. Para nuestro desastre natural número 9, estamos poniendo dos diferentes. Two different natural disasters together because they are very similar. Okay. Dos desastres naturales juntos porque son muy similares. So we have avalanche and landslide. So the two things that I am putting into the same category is an avalanche and a landslide. So, an avalanche, which is also known as a snow slide, is what happens oftentimes in the mountains when pieces of snow start melting and breaking away and they fall down to the slide of the mountain or down the side of a slope. And as the snow is falling, it becomes faster and greater. More and more snow and debris along the way and can injure or kill people who are in the area. Okay, but avalanche is a large amount of ice. Aquí tenemos dos diferentes, pero que son parecidos, no lo he puesto juntos. Snow light is like says avalancha de nieve. Okay, it's a large amount of ice, ¿no? Una gran cantidad de hielo, nieve o rocas cayendo de una montaña. Que puede dañar, obviamente, a las personas que están cerca. Says avalanche often cause lots of damage of people who are skiing or snowboarding or enjoying areas near the mountains, ¿no? Las avalanchas pueden causar mucho daño a las personas que están esquiando o haciendo snowboarding o disfrutando de las áreas cerca de la montaña. Whereas landslide is the same idea, only instead of snow melting and falling down, it is usually caused by erosion of the soil, lots of rain that had happened, and land will actually fall down the slope. Okay, so snowslide is different. So the landslide is different. So it is like avalancha de lodo, no? So avalanche, that is a snowslide, is avalancha de nieve. And landslide, that is like mudslide, avalancha de lodo, no? A mass of rock, una masa de rocas, and earth moving suddenly and quickly down a steep slope, no? Masa de roca, de tierra moviéndose. And sunlight can also be called mudslide in some places. And so a landslide can also be called a mudslide. Literally just mud and water entered in other debris clouds. Pick it up along the way, gains speed and just whoosh. Can without roads, can wipe out towns and so on. No, it's something all different. So today we learned about 9 different types of natural disasters, along with many useful vocabulary words that you can use to discuss this topic. And now it's time for question of the day. So today's question is, have you ever experienced a natural disaster? Okay. Los hemos visto 9 desastres naturales. We know that there are more, no, sabemos que hay más. Obviously you can talk about that, no, ustedes van a hablar sobre el resto de depending your homework, right? Dependiendo de la tarea. Hemos aprendido esos 9 desastres naturales que lo podemos usar en diferentes vocabularios, ¿no? Para discutir varios de este tema. So, our question, you're gonna answer a question, ya vamos a responder una pregunta, says, have you ever experienced a natural disaster? ¿Han experimentado algún desastre natural? So, you know that this answer is gonna be in your homework, right? Recuerden que esta respuesta va a ir en su tarea, depending on the other words, dependiendo con las diferentes preguntas, right? So, Lexi, see you to our next video, and good luck.